Get ready to match the stars. McLean Stevenson. Loretta Switz. Stu Gillum. Brett Somers. Richard Dawson. And Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Bunny Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Oh. Hey. Hello there. Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello, ladies. Thank you, Johnny Olson.
Talk about pretty.
You're a dandy bunch.
Oh, thank you.
Coconuts, and we're delighted to have all of your beautiful bodies here, especially yours, Anne. Not you, her, I'm talking to.
Yes, I like a girl with pretty red dress. And I'll tell you why.
Now I'd like to greet you and have you greet our two players here, Sheila Domes and Beverly Ventimiglia. Let's welcome them. Ladies, last time out, we had finished round one, and at the end of round one, the score is 2-0 in favor of our current champ, who has a total of $1,750 to her credit. And this lady here, and she's happy about that. And Sheila didn't do too well the first round, but we got round two to go to, Sheila, so just hold on there and hang in there, and we'll get to it right after we get to this. All right, here we go, ladies. If you're all set, we'll finish the game. We started last time out. And as we go to round two, I point out to you, Sheila, you must match two celebrities to stay in the game. Please make a selection.
A.
A is what she wants, and this is it. Everyone participates. Here is your assignment. Herman nearly blanked his nose off. Herman nearly blanked his nose off.
Okay, sweetheart.
Herman nearly blanked his nose off. Are you thinking about that, Sheila? Okay. Sheila will attempt to think of an answer that will match our celebrities.
Whoops.
Okay.
No being at the bride before the wedding, dear.
Here we go, Sheila. They're all ready, so we'll get your response to this. Herman nearly blanked his nose off.
Shot.
He nearly what?
Shot.
Shot?
S-H-O-T.
Herman nearly shot his nose off.
Did anybody tell her about violence on television this year?
Sheila Domes, that's what she said. What do you say, McLean?
Well, I wouldn't say that, but what I did say was that Herman nearly blew his nose off.
Nearly blew his nose off. Okay.
Not funny, but accurate.
Loretta, what did you say here? She's looking for shots.
Yes, he nearly blew his nose off.
Blue seems to be the answer so far. Stu, do you blue?
I think that she definitely has a problem. Had she thought of a handkerchief instead of a gun, she'd know that he blew his nose off.
Blew his nose off.
Okay. You know why Herman blew his nose off? Because he had a terrible cold. He blew his nose off.
Blue, so far it's happened four times. You must match the two remaining celebrities with your answer, shot, or the game is over. Go, Richard.
Well, you'll need this answer like you need a shot in the nose. Blue.
Blue, it doesn't match, so Beverly Ventimiglia wins again. Congratulations. Right around here. There. Here you are again. Well, she's done this so many times. She's won five games now, and she knows how to make her way around here. Sheila, it's been a pleasure meeting you. We've got a gift for you. We thank you for being with us on Match Game 73. Sheila Doan. All right, everything is in place. Beverly, are you ready?
Right.
All right, here we go with the super match here. We'll go to the audience match part of it first. We polled a recent studio audience and got their best response to this. Rubber blank. The answer given most often by that audience is worth $500 if you match it. Second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. Now you can get three celebrities to help suggest answers for you, so you can call on them one at a time now.
Richard?
Rubber duck.
Rubber duck is what he says. So there's one answer for you.
I get in the tub with one every day.
McLean, would you like to give an answer to this?
Yes, I would like to give an answer to this.
Good. Please tell us what your answer is.
Rubber band.
Rubber band is the plane's answer. All right, one more, Beverly.
Stu.
He said rubber band, right?
Right, we've got rubber duck and rubber
hose.
Rubber hose.
Hose.
He did that.
In third degree. Yes.
Okay, that's it. So you got rubber band, rubber hose, and rubber duck. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own, but we need your answer now.
I'll go with rubber band.
Rubber band is the answer McLean gave you. That's the one she thinks is going to be the winner. We'll find out right now. We're looking for rubber band. May we see the $100 response? Rubber tire is the first
That's
one.
That's what I have.
Is that what you had?
Oh, you do. No, around me.
Oh, you have one now.
I've been using polyester lately.
Here we go. Still looking for a rubber band. May we see the $250 response? Rubber ball is there. No rubber band yet. Let's all hope it's here now for her sake. Here is the $500 response.
Yay!
Rubber band it is. You blow him a kiss?
Yes.
Big stuff.
I have to watch out.
Just so you can blow him a kiss. I can't, but you can. You can blow her a kiss back if you'd like.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Whatever's fair.
Now, you've got the $500. That means you're going to play for 10 times that amount now, or $5,000. Now, to collect that amount of money, you know you've got to match one celebrity head-to-head, and it's time to pick a celebrity.
Richard Dawson.
He's your man, you say. Okay, Richard, you get ready to write. Beverly, you'll face me. I'll get the $5,000 question out of the slot here. Here it is, Richard. Please write your answer to this. Blank father. Okay, he's finished. Beverly, how do you fill in that blank? Blank father.
Grandfather.
Grandfather. All right, Richard, for $5,000, may we see your answer, and it must be an exact match.
Well, you see, I made an offer I didn't think she could refuse.
Did you think of that?
Yes.
You thought of godfather and grandfather, and you chose grandfather. Well, don't cry, my dear. You're still our champion. You've got over $2,000. You got $2,350. That ain't bad. You're still a champ. You're going to meet another player. Here comes Margie Dale. Hello there, Margie.
Hi.
Okay, you ladies know each other, do you?
Yes.
All right, Margie, we welcome you. Thank you for joining us here on Match Game 73. Would you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Well, I graduated from UCLA last year, and now I'm working in advertising and promotion.
All right. Anything else you want to offer to us?
Anything you want to know especially?
Well, I don't know.
I'm a stranger in town.
No, that's
not right. You direct me to your house?
That's enough of that.
And it's Studio City.
Okay,
and
that's enough. Now, you know that you and Beverly will be answering questions, trying to match our six celebrities. The one who's done that most often at the end of the second round will be the winner, and we'll have a go at the super match where you can win over $5,000. All right, Margie, we ask you to make your selection here.
B.
B is what she wants, and this is it. Everyone plays. Lorraine was ejected from the movie theater for throwing her blank over the balcony.
I hate these.
Now, so let's write something on the card. It's a serious program with a lot of money at stake here.
Throwing her.
Lorraine was... Are you thinking about that, Margie?
Okay. I'm thinking.
And you will attempt to come up with an answer in a moment or so that will match our six celebrities there, or as many of them as you think. Ready, Stu?
Yeah, I'm ready. It's just a machine here today.
Oh, all right. Now, everybody's ready. Margie, so would you give us your response to this? Lorraine was ejected from the movie theater for throwing her blank over the balcony.
Popcorn.
Popcorn, she says. They're throwing her popcorn over the balcony, is what she says. That's the answer she hopes will match you, McLean.
Well, of course she does, but silly goose, I said her husband.
I would imagine the theater would eject her for that. Yes.
Oh, I don't think the theater would put her out, but the police might object.
Yeah, they would object. Loretta, what did you say?
Well, popcorn.
Popcorn is a match. Steve, popcorn is her answer. What's yours?
Well, I had the same idea, only I was trying to cover a wider area, so I said cup that you would have the drink in.
Cup. Okay, a little soda cup or something like that. Brett, we're looking for the answer, popcorn.
You know, I could have said husband, but Jack and I made up.
Oh, you did? Good.
Yes. Marriage is off the rocks, folks. I want you to realize that we're getting on very well, so we don't have to worry about us for another 3 days. So I said coat!
Coat. Threw her coat over the balcony.
Neither funny nor accurate.
No.
That's sincere.
That's right. A very sincere answer. Richard?
What have you got down there?
There's an alligator. Don't put your down.
You don't feed him. They go bananas.
What did I...
Yes, Lorraine was ejected from the theater for throwing her blank over the balcony. What did you answer?
She did spill her drink and her popcorn, and she, you know, had to get rid of it, so she threw her undies. I wasn't with her, so I said, hearsay.
Okay. Popcorn is her answer, Anne.
And after she threw the undies over, then she threw her date over.
Okay, I'll teach you to go see Deep Throat.
With the hat, the score is 1-0 at this moment. We'll get to your end of the round, Beverly. But first, we've got to get to this, and then hurry right back. All right, here we go, folks. We've finished the first half of the round. Now, Beverly, we get to your half of the round. And this is it. Everyone plays. Sally said, I went dancing with a guy called Pinocchio last night and got a splinter in my blank. Sally said that. I went dancing with a guy called Pinocchio last night. Come on now.
Which hand am I supposed to write?
Oh, you're the southpaw.
She went dancing with who?
With a guy called Pinocchio. Got a splinter in my blank is what
I can
said.
Tell you where she got a splinter on it.
Okay, we're just about set, I guess. Yes, we are. So, Beverly, we call for your response now. I went dancing with a guy called Pinocchio last night and got a splinter in my...
shoulder.
In my shoulder. I guess that would be logical. Let's see if his nose were... Yeah, that would...
How all tall right. was he?
Well, I don't know how tall. Well,
how short was she?
We've got a doctor. Would you tell us what you see down there, doctor?
I'm terribly sorry. I can't be bothered now. I think I've just discovered the cure for the common hickey.
We've got a call for your answer.
Yeah, sorry.
The answer the lady gave to this, I went dancing with a guy called Pinocchio last night, got a splinter in my shoulders, what she said, what do you say to that?
Really? I'll tell you what I say to that.
Yeah, tell me what you say to that.
I say ear to that.
In my ear to that. Okay, no match there. Looking for shoulder, Loretta.
Shoulder.
What have you got?
Close. Neck.
Neck. All right. Still haven't got a shoulder.
Now, that's a hickey you get.
For some reason, I've always admired Jimmy Durante, and he always is covered by a bevy of ladies, and since his outstanding feature is the same as Pinocchio's, I said that she got a splinter in her lip.
In her lip. No shoulder yet. No various parts of the anatomy, Beverly. Let's see what you have, Brett.
Well, in my youth, I went out with some guys, and I got a splinter a lot of places, but and particularly my lip, and they didn't necessarily have to be made of wood.
Okay. No match yet. Looking for the word shoulder.
I wish I'd said that.
Day. If you ever go out with a girl with a toothpick in her mouth, you'll get a splinter in your lip, too.
I'm glad I didn't say that. I said neck.
Neck. No shoulder yet. Anne, it's up to you.
Yeah, well, they were dancing, unfortunately, nose to nose.
Nose to nose. And got a splinter in her nose. So, Beverly, you didn't score with that, and we'll go to round two right now. 1-0 in favor of the challenger at the end of round one. Margie, what do you say here?
I'll try B again.
B again. Last time out, you matched Loretta, so you'll be trying to match everyone but her this time. Oh, no, cried Harry.
Oh, I love it. I got
you just ate Selma, my pet blank. How was the reading?
It was a very good reading, Gene.
Shall I do it again?
Fine. We'll let you know. We're going to see a lot of guys, but it was very good.
Okay. Do you understand it?
He just ate his what?
Oh, no, cried Harry. You just ate Selma, my pet blank.
My pet?
Do I get the part?
You're too tall.
I'll let you know. Thank you anyway.
My all right. Pet.
My pet. Looking for a girl with it.
Now we're all set.
Yes.
Okay.
My last. Yeah.
Now, Margie, how did you fill in that blank? Oh, no, cried Harry, you just ate Selma, my pet.
Spider.
Spider.
Oh, no.
Oh, no, cried Harry.
Not again, Gene. We have the question.
I think there's something wrong with
Harry
it.
Dracula is his name. Harry Dracula.
What do you say, yes. McLean?
I said, oh, no, cried Harry, you've eaten my pet. Snake.
Snake. No match yet, Margie, Loretta?
Spider.
I mean, Stu?
My tastes are slightly more towards the gourmet side. I thought of something at least edible. I thought that possibly she might have a pet frog.
Ate my pet frog. Okay, no spider yet. That's the answer she's looking for, Brett.
Oh, no, cried Harry. You've eaten my pet snake.
My pet snake. All right, Richard?
They're weird people. They eat snakes and frogs. We eat hens at our house. Of course, they're not our pets.
All right.
Poor remind devil. Me to invite you over my house for a chitlin'
oh,
dinner.
Spider, no, cried Anne.
Harry.
Harry ate a pet fish.
A pet fish. Okay. Gosh. So you didn't score with that. Now we'll go to Beverly's end of the round. Beverly, you must... we'll go to your end of the round in a moment or so, but we've got a little business to take care of. We'll do that now, so hurry right back. Now we're going to finish this round. Beverly, you must score one match to stay in the game. Two, however, will win another game for you. It'll be your sixth win if it happens. Here we go. John's a little strange. He sent out engraved invitations to his blank. Are you thinking about that?
I'm thinking.
Okay. Is that lady molesting you?
Pardon? I've been yes, he wishes.
Everybody ready? We don't. I mean, we appreciate your artwork, but we really would like to get on with it. Thank you very much. Okay, here we go. Beverly, John's a little strange. He sent out engraved invitations to his...
party.
Party. All right. She said party. She's got to score one match to stay in the game. Two will win it. McLean, what did you say?
I said his funeral.
To his funeral. Party is your answer, Loretta?
Yes. Well, I was going to say funeral. It was a bit too somber, so I made him really strange. His birth, he
his
said.
His birth. Okay.
Okay.
Stu.
Moving right on.
I know there.
I felt that it would be rather weird if John sent out invitations to his operation.
To his operation. Come and watch my
yes,
appendectomy.
Come see the opening.
Right. Oh, yeah. Okay. No match yet. Her answer is party. She must score one to stay in the game. Brett.
I don't think there's any... funeral is as strange as birth. I said wake.
Wake.
Yeah.
All right, Richard, it's...
I only wish you had seen a wake. Funeral.
Funeral seems to be the answer. You must match Anne to stay in the game. If not, Margie will be the winner.
Sorry.
Funeral! So you've got a new champion, Margie Dale. Congratulations. Could you step around, please? Okay, congratulations to you. Beverly, you'll be leaving here with $2,350, and our thanks for being on Match Game 73. Goodbye. There goes Beverly Ventimiglia. Now, let's see how far we can get here with this Superman. You have a chance to go at $5,000. You ready?
Yes.
All right. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank Tower. Now, you know how the answers are worth $500, $250, and $100. You can get some help from their celebrities, so choose them one at a time.
Ann Elder.
What do you say, Ann? How do you fill that in?
Eiffel.
Eiffel Tower is one.
Brett.
London.
London Tower is two.
And Stu.
And Stu. What do you
Leaning.
Say?
Yeah.
Leaning Tower. So you've got a Leaning Tower, a London Tower, and the Eiffel Tower. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own if you wish.
I like Eiffel Tower.
You like Eiffel Tower. Okay, we're looking for Eiffel Tower. May we see the $100 response? Ivory Tower. Oh, that's not a bad answer.
I never would have thought of that.
Here's still looking for the Eiffel Tower. May we see the $250 response? Leaning Tower is up there, one Stu gave you. Last chance for Eiffel Tower. Here is the $500 response. Yes. Very good, Ann. All right. We congratulate you, and we're going to tell you what's going to happen right after this happens. We'll get right back to you.
Margie Dale will be back next time to have a go at $5,000, and I hope you'll come back, too. And will you come back, too?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Uncle G.
I'm so happy. You know, I want all of you to know that McLean is a writer in addition to being a fine actor. You're writing one of the MASH episodes, are you?
The graffiti on the restroom wall.
He just can't spell it.
Okay, we look forward to seeing that. Gene Webern saying so long for Match Game 73. Bye.
Today's consolation prizes are a supply of Adolph's Instant Meat Tenderizer. Helps make meat tender, juicy, and delicious. Any kind of meat can taste even better. Adolph's, the original meat tenderizer. And the Weekender by American Tourister, designed to go everywhere by land, sea, or air. Fiberglass reinforced construction. Strong, lightweight luggage by American Tourister. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Tubman production.